Hey folks, my name is Jared Mananen, and I'd like to welcome you to my monthly newsletter. At the beginning of each month, I publish a newsletter filled with photos, videos, artwork, links to my other projects, and an essay that I hope will provide food for thought and a starting point for meaningful conversation. Keep in mind, however, that these video versions of my newsletters have been modified from their original format. So if you want to read any of my previous newsletters, visit jaredmananen.com. Thoughts about 100 days and counting. For the past few years, I've made it my goal to cross-country ski at least 100 days each winter. Now, keep in mind that this doesn't actually mean that I've skied all day on every one of those 100 days. As you probably know, I'm not a professional athlete, and I do occasionally have other commitments to keep. So some of my ski days are technically only about 30 to 45 minutes, or some of them may go on longer, but I might only cover a very short distance during that time. That may come as a surprise or even a disappointment to some people, that is, that I don't actually ski all day long during every training session. But cross-country skiing is a workout after all, and I wouldn't really expect most people to work out for hours on end every time they went to the gym or on a run. Cross-country skiing also happens to be very technique-oriented, so although I do travel many miles over the course of many hours on certain days, I probably spend an equal amount of time only focusing on refining one small aspect of a bigger technical movement. The bottom line is that becoming proficient at anything requires us to find that balance between the big picture and its smaller parts. So again, I vary my training between long and short distances and aerobically and technically oriented sessions. I also do this as a way in which to pace myself. Honestly, if I try to grind out 24 miles every time I cross-country skied, I'd either develop a serious case of tendonitis in every joint of my lower body, or I'd mentally burn out. Most likely, I'd end up suffering both afflictions in short order. Again, I'm not a pro athlete, and I do like to do other things. That, and I'm not getting any younger. As they say, it's not so much about the time, but rather the miles on the body that ages us. So mixing it up is critical to seeing a longer-term goal through to its completion. I choose 100 days because it's a good number for me. First and foremost, it's a goal that's actually achievable, assuming the snow cooperates. Add a low snow winter to the equation, and that goal becomes even more difficult to achieve. Either way, though, I personally find that doing anything consistently for 100 days in a time frame that can last 150 days or less is pretty challenging. There's simply not a lot of room for error with those numbers. So in my opinion, logging 100 days of skiing each winter is a relatively serious goal and commitment. But this is the type of goal that I want to embrace, the kind where it's both realistic, but also includes plenty of legitimate challenges. Essentially, when we're goal setting, we want to set our sights high enough so that there's always something for which to reach. Otherwise, life just becomes too easy, right? I wouldn't necessarily call it demoralizing, but I do tend to find it underwhelming and a bit of a letdown when I achieve my goal in a fraction of the effort or time that I set aside to work on it. For example, rather than feeling celebratory upon its completion because of all the effort and skill that I put into the endeavor, I usually just feel meh about it. This is because I know I set too low of a bar for myself and that I can accomplish so much more. As a lifelong competitor, in one form or another, I know just how unsatisfying an easy win can be. This stems from the fact that those easy wins just don't create enough pressure to truly test us. So we end up logging a hollow victory and wondering what the point of it all was. In contrast, and regardless of outcome, knowing that we pulled out all the stops and left everything on the mat or the track is the essence of living a meaningful and fulfilling life. As a bonus, when we go back to unpack the experience in an effort to determine what we could do better next time, we have lots of data from which to evaluate. Some people might argue with this, but I truly believe that every single person secretly desires to be the hero in their own story. And what I mean by this is that we all want to, at one point or another, be the person who overcomes great odds to achieve a monumental victory. It doesn't matter how big or small that quote-unquote monumental victory actually is, because it's all individually relative. However, we all want to experience that same feeling of having put forth a great effort that led to making a positive impact on the world. Obviously, cross-country skiing 100 times each winter is not exactly something that's going to reshape the world for the better, but it's an example of how leading a goal-oriented life can simulate the experience of becoming the hero in our own story. We embrace a challenging goal, and then we employ all of our skills, talents, and resources to overcome whatever challenges we're faced with in pursuit of that goal. And hopefully when we're through, whatever results we've achieved have inspired others to attempt their own challenging goal, and just as important, revealed something about ourselves that was previously hidden. I couldn't imagine living life any other way. In other words, find something that you're passionate about and then go after it with everything you've got. Okay, folks, we've reached the end of this presentation, so I thank you for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed the show. If so, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any feedback or questions, post it in the comment section below. If you want to read previous newsletters, visit jaredmananin.com and then check out my backcountry blog, tahotrailguide.com, where I offer information about hiking, backpacking, cross-country skiing, and snowshoeing at Lake Tahoe. I also write general and how-to articles about those activities, as well as informative articles about Sierra Nevada, flora and fauna, and the local history of Lake Tahoe. Thanks again, and take care, everyone.